Day 79 of the NHL lockout, and a report out of Boston where a fairly powerful NHL figure by the name of Jeremy Jacobs hangs out has this labor dispute coming to an end in the next 48 hours. We'll see. In the meantime, the two sides will try a new approach Tuesday as Gary Bettman and Donald Fehr will give way to a meeting between six owners and six players. We get more from Darren Millard, Big Nick Kiprios, and John Shannon.
Thank you very much. The original proposal was players and owners. Now they're allowed one more staffer. It doesn't really reflect Gary Bettman's idea. So, Nick, I'm going to put it into football terminology for you because we haven't played hockey in a while. Is this running out the clock or is it Doug Flutie Hail Mary?
Yeah, it might be a Hail Mary. You got to remember when Gary threw out this idea last week in suburban New Jersey, Thursday, it was almost when everybody was putting their jackets on, leaving the room. So it seems like he's grasping at straws here a little bit. And what turned out, in essence, what's supposed to be a player-owner-only meeting has kind of changed a little bit. And that was obviously through the NHL. They had put certain stipulations on which owners can be involved. And the other one was obviously that only one member from each side who wasn't an owner or a player can be in this meeting. Me, I would have preferred it to be opened up. I would have involved general managers, maybe even a couple agents, some real stakeholders
but this,
in this thing.
This looks more like a regular bargaining session.
Well,
as opposed to
except it's not a bargaining session. This is, truthfully, this is just an information session of where both sides stand and where the other side is supposed to understand the importance of certain issues. To me, I think there's one key issue, and it all goes to scratch. It all goes to money, and the owners are at $211 million in making a whole, and the players are at $393. And is there some way the six players and six owners and the staffers can actually sit down and say, can we get to $300? Can we make a move to make the whole payments and the contracted players get all their money or as much money as possible, and we have a chance to get a CBA. I'm not suggesting it's going to happen, that's
the best case scenario is maybe a couple of those new owners like Vinnick or Burkle from Pittsburgh can go back Wednesday into the Board of Governors meeting and say, hey, they're not really stalling the players. They want to get a deal done, so let's get it done.
Canada's had a chip on their shoulder for a long time against Gary Bettman.
They have.
The seven Canadian teams well represented.
50% of the owners of the six are going to be Canadian, and I'll tell you what, they got the big league, the big money in Toronto, and Larry Tannenbaum, Mark Chipman, the new kid on the block, and they've got Murray Edwards, and I think, you talk about Vinnick and Burkle being key, I think Murray Edwards, who's the principal owner of the Calgary Flames, is key to this. He's been part of the whole process from the beginning of negotiation. There he is with Jeremy Jacobs of the Bruins. And I think Murray Edwards carries in the cards the similar opportunity that Harley Hotchkiss had in 2004 and 5 to make a deal. Murray Edwards, I think, is going to be the key.
The three Canadian owners involved, the rich, the respected, the rookie, and we're all hoping for a resolution.